First of all, can we just look at how gorgeous I look in yellow? Hey, this is my second video in yellow, and I think this color is doing wonders. I look divine. Almost as divine as this tea right here, and the tea I'm about to serve to you. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. So, without any further ado, let's just get into it. Hello. It's me, Tendo Limbo, and welcome to my channel, Tea Time with Tendo Limbo.
Hello, my name is Tanda. Nice to know you. Tanda.
Alright, let me just explain why I'm wearing yellow. I wanted to dedicate this video to a dear friend of mine, Luyolo, who passed away this past weekend. And yellow is his favorite color. And when I tell you he is a sweet, kind, gentle soul, believe me, you. Because, yeah, man, I can't even get to explain how warm and kind he was towards me and many other people. And I just hope that his soul rests in peace. I don't want to talk much about it simply because I don't want to cry again. So, yeah.
You're my reason to believe in.
This is a dedication to you, my friend, and may your soul rest in peace. With that out of the way, girl, I am. Yeah, let's get into this. Get in the zone, Tendo, get in the zone. All right, first story today. Tory Lanez just got deported. Oh yes, oh yes. So Tory Lanez got deported from America back to his home country, Canada, following his arrest. His arrest that linked him to having a gun in his possession, which under speculation also has to do with him being the one in. I just forgot the word, so let me change my sentence. Also, I'm changing my sentence. I can't remember this word. Okay, and it also has to do with him being the person who is speculated, assumed to be the person who shot Megan Thee Stallion just a few weeks ago, 2, 3 weeks ago. So Megan Thee Stallion, not much has been said about this case. It is literally one of the most private cases, very secret. And I mean, as the much that we know is simply because these are famous people. Do you get what I mean? So what we do know is that yes, Megan Thee Stallion did confirm she got shot. All right, she got shot on both legs. I spoke about this in last week's video. I spoke about this in last week's video, and basically, Megan Thee Stallion got shot on both her legs. She's okay. She's fine. She got the bullets out. And I also showed you a video. Ooh, child, I've got receipts. The week before that, I showed you a video with Megan, Tory Lanez, and a friend getting out of a car, and you could see Megan bleeding. So, I mean, it's just been very, very messy. But yeah, Tory Lanez is back in Canada. He's been deported, and he'll come back when there are set dates to appear in court with regards to this whole thing. I think that the court is just waiting for Megan Thee Stallion to heal, recover, get better, and the cases, or I don't know, it's, I guess the word is cases until the cases begin. I don't know if I'm making sense. I just don't know the right words. But let's move on. Let's move on. And moving on. Oh, still talking about Megan Thee Stallion. Megan Thee Stallion has a new song coming out this Friday with Cardi B. It's called WAP, WAP. And girl, this is the cover art. It looks cute. I'm here for it. Give it to me. Give it to me. Give it to me. And let me tell you why I'm here for it. It is because I know the song's gonna have some cute And ew, grrr, you know, all of that. It's just gonna be one wretched song that I know I'm just gonna twerk to. So I'm super excited for this. And oh, I have a strong feeling. Now we're dealing with two girls that can dance, two rappers that can dance. You know, rap, female rappers aren't known to be the biggest dancers, performers, you know? I mean, let me not say performance, but like, yeah. So Cardi B can dance. That we know. Megan Stallion can dance. These girls can twerk. And guess what that means? This music video gonna be fire! Because Beyonce's choreographer, Jaquiel Knight, posted the cover art for this music video. I mean, for the song WAP that's coming out on Friday. And he's worked with Beyonce, like, many times. He's worked with her for Single Ladies, Formation, Coachella. So trust and believe. When I say we're going to get an iconic music video, believe me, you, we are going to get an iconic music video. That's it. It's going to be a huge song. It's going to be a bad. I don't even know how it sounds, but I reassure, I am telling you right now, Friday, don't say I didn't tell you. And into more news, still international, the VMAs have been announced, nominees have been announced, categories have been announced, and they are happening on the 30th of August at the end of this month. And of course, it's going to be virtual, you know, with the whole pandemic and everything. I feel like almost everything is virtual nowadays, but I guess that's our new normal. And the VMAs are happening on the 30th of August. No idea who the host is going to be. No idea who's going to perform. But I do know some of the categories and the nominees, all right? And for category four, Video of the Year, we have Rain on Me. Okay. It's got a cute choreography. Let me not judge. And I also want, yay. Yay. Let me not say anything about Rain on Me. I don't hate it, but I just don't think it's going to win. So we're going to have Rain on Me, Everything I Wanted by Billie Eilish. We're going to have Blinding Lights by The Weeknd, Life is Good by Drake, and many more, as well as another category of Song of the Year, Artist of the Year, which also includes DaBaby, Megan Thee Stallion, Lady Gaga, The Weeknd, Post Malone. Who else? Justin Bieber. I was like, girl, really? But anyways, Justin Bieber's also there. There's many, many, many more categories. So, I mean, I'm excited. I hope you're excited. I don't know why. Oh, let me tell you why I'm excited for the VMAs, okay? I feel like the VMAs, for me, have been not on the award side, but on the entertainment side, they've been very good. Like, for me, personally, Tendo, Limbo, they've been very good on the entertainment side, the performances, all of that. And I hope that, yes, although it's virtual, they'll still deliver. I mean, come on now. This is, Video Music Awards. They, girl, you have to deliver. You have to deliver. And talking about more award shows, the South African Music Awards Summer 26 started last night on a Monday. Today's a Tuesday, so there'll be another episode basically from the 3rd to the 7th of August at 9:30 till 10 o'clock on Zanzi Magic Channel 161 on DSTV. That's where the summers are going to be happening. They seem virtual. They don't seem live. They seem virtual. And the first episode, I watched the first episode last night so I can report, and yeah, man, choices, and that was a choice. I mean, I didn't enjoy them personally. I didn't enjoy them. No, I didn't enjoy them at all. No. They were so boring. They were so boring. But let me tell you what was nice. The nicest part was the opening, you know. The opening was by Ndlovu Youth Choir. That's the best I think they've sounded vocally. It was quite cute. A bit too animated, but cute. Danera Langa and Donovan Goliath looked cute in their outfits. The Amakhosa outfits that they wore. I thought that was cute. But besides that, I thought they were boring. The performances were just music videos. I mean, okay. Let me not lie. I skipped the channel. I was switching channels here and there because of how boring they were. I hope they'll get better the next 4 days. Tonight, tomorrow, the day after, the day after that. I hope. Yeah. I just hope so. That's all. And into more news. Oh, before we even move on, let me just tell you some of the winners. And get an eye watched. So some of the winners for, what you call this? Best in traditional faith gospel album, Dumi's Mkokstad won for his album, Calvary. Best collaboration, K.O. and Nandi Madida won for Say You Will. Best Africa, rest of Africa, that means like including, because this is South African Music Awards, so someone else from somewhere else in Africa. Davido won for A Good Time, his album A Good Time. Then there was Maskandiwi and all of that. Da 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 da. So, I mean, I didn't gag. It wasn't gag worthy. I'm hoping for the best for the rest of the four parts of this year's Summer Awards. Because, wow. Yeah, no, hey, even like, that should not be an excuse, personally. But hey, I'm gonna move on right now. Moving on, something else that I found extremely boring. A very boring year. I mean, you know what, let me not lie. For Bonang to do what he just did is like a very like big ups to her. Definitely you've reached a level where you can travel the world and have camera crews follow you. You can document your life. That is amazing, girl. That is amazing. Big ups to you. But I mean, why am I watching what I already saw on your stories last year? I promise you, I saw Oras on her stories last year around this time. No, not this time, but like sometime last year. Probably around March-ish, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, it doesn't matter when last year. What matters is that I did see this last year. I did see Oras resurface. That was like one of her friends that she was with in a very bonang year. I did see what she's doing last year when she was in New York and all of that. So for me to then watch this again on SABC 1, I'm like, girl, really now? But, I mean, of course, her fans might have enjoyed it. I didn't. I found it very boring. Maybe it's because I hold Bonang at such a high standard. And she's entertained me better on being Bonang, her reality show. So for this, I was just like, okay. Those who enjoyed, enjoyed. But regardless, it was a cute thing. It was cute. Not gag-worthy. Not out of this world. Mind-blowing. I don't even know if she can... Bonang is known for reaction videos. She gets reaction videos after being Bonang, catchphrases, all of that. I don't think there was anything after that first episode of her two-part documentary series thing. So, will I watch the second part? Maybe. I don't know. If I have nothing else to do, probably. But if not busy, I'll watch it. I'm not going to go out of my way for it. And also... Maybe I sound bitter because I got blocked. Basically, Mugele blocked me and... Let's not even go there. She blocked me straight after her reality show. Can you believe it? For my opinion. And I didn't even tag it. I didn't even say it on her pictures. Basically, someone tagged her under my tweet. I was so sad. But anyways... My opinion is very objective. Let me say that. My opinion is very objective of her very bonang year. It's not a bad thing. It's just she's done so well and so good. And I've seen her do better than what he produced. My opinion. That's it. My opinion. But moving along. Black is king. Let me tell you something, all right? This is not going to be a review. This is not a reaction. This is just... I'm going to keep this as short as possible, this Black is King segment, because if I get into it, Lala, if I get into it, it's over. If I get into it, we might as well just transform this into a live. Because what Beyoncé did in... that is the best hour and a half of my life. I cannot even begin to explain. Let me tell you something. That was a perfect, 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 okay? It, oh, goodness. Her storytelling is out of this world. And the thing, she had to work by herself and she credited those that needed to be credited. But you know what she did? She did research and she knew what she was doing. And she showed African culture and she had an African story. She took just an animation story and gave it so much meaning and value. And made it so connectable to Africans, made them proud to be African, showed them doing their culture their way, and it being glorified, which I thought was amazing. And even in the beginning, she said, let black be synonymous for glory. Girl, she did that. Come on now, Mustang. Come on now. So Black is King was a dedication to her son, Sir Carter. And also, when it started, she started with Bigger. Girl, that bitch rented out the ocean. She rented out the desert. She looked beautiful. She looked beautiful. The outfits, she had over 80 outfits within an hour and a half. The artists that she worked with, I mean, Yemi Alade looked gorgeous, Tiwa Savage, Busiso, Moonchild Sanelli, Nandi Madida, Warren Masumela, Connie Ish, I can't pronounce the surname, yo, also Young Simba, Old Simba, I just look, oh my gosh, everyone did the level best, and it showed. It showed it was good. And to think that this was done last year and they all kept quiet. They all kept quiet. It was a non-disclosure and people adhered to it. And you know what's crazy? No paparazzi, no leaks, no nothing. Now that is what I call professionalism at its best, at its peak. Girls, you better learn from her. You better learn from her. It was absolutely amazing. Such a joy to watch. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I was happy. Gab worthy. When I tell you, she looked beautiful. Everyone looked beautiful. The choreography looked beautiful. If I could dance, I would have inserted like a video of myself doing some of the choreography. I'm not... oh, come on now. Come on. Black is King was absolutely beautiful. When I tell you budget, I mean it. The budget was extraordinary. And you know what she did? She gave us a deluxe album for The Gift, which I loved. The only complaint is that why was the Black is King spirit song, that version, why was it not in the deluxe? That and Mood Forever. Because I loved the Black is King version. But just understand and believe me, if you haven't watched it, you better watch it. If you've watched it, you know what I'm talking about. And if you don't like it, watch it again, because you might be a little bit too slow to understand what was going on. But child, I've already watched it 5 times already. I'm gonna watch it for the sixth time tonight, because why not? Come on. If it's nice, do it twice, thrice, and many more times. But anyways, that is the end of this video. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe somewhere down below. If you have, please thank you so much for watching. And please give this a big thumbs up. Don't forget to comment, like, share, tell a friend to tell another friend to tell another friend. And yeah. Thank you so much, and arrivederci, toodaloo, and